In this video, I'll show you how to wireframe for mobile in Adobe XD. I've already made a few videos on wireframing in the past, including how to create your own wireframe kit. I'll leave a link below to those videos if you want to check them out after this one. But in those videos, I mostly focused on the desktop experience. So in this video, I wanted to take those same wireframes and create mobile-friendly versions. You'll notice that as I'm creating these wireframes, I'm dragging and dropping, copying and pasting elements that I've already created, which were part of the wireframe kit that I made. This makes your wireframing process so much easier and faster because you're not continuing to create elements from scratch. Instead, you're focusing your time on the layout, the flow, and how the experience should be. Once you create an element that you use over and over in a wireframe, make that into a component. To do this in Adobe XD, you can press Command K as a keyboard shortcut or right click and choose Make Component. There's also an option where you can press the plus button sign above the components on the left side of the screen. Once you do this, you'll notice that the element now has a green box over it with a diamond icon in the top left-hand corner. This reminds you that this is a component. You can even create components within components. Note that when you change a component, it will not actually change the original component, but only that instance. If you wanted to change the original component so that the changes would carry through to all the instances of it, you would need to right-click and select Edit Main Component or keyboard shortcut Shift-Command-K. This will move your screen to that first instance of the component, and then you can change it from there. I ended up using a lot of the same components I created for the desktop versions as I did for the mobile version. But as I went along, I made sure to rename them with something like dash mobile, so I would know that this was a mobile component versus the other ones, which are desktop components. I also like to keep things in alphabetical order so that it's easier for me to find what I'm looking for. I'll go in and clean up my components later. An example of a new component I created specifically for mobile wireframes is the hamburger menu icon. For most of the other components, for example, body one or H1 center or logo or any of the photo ones, I basically was just changing the size so that they would fit better for mobile. Another thing to keep in mind when creating your mobile versions of your wireframes is to think about how the layout changes. For example, I have a lot of instances of three columns in my desktop version, which wouldn't work for mobile. Instead, it's just going to go to a one column stacked. As these are just wireframes, you don't need to get too detailed with your measurements or design details. Wireframes are the skeleton of your website. You could even start on pen and paper first before doing them digitally. But the purpose of this is so that you have a map going forward to create your design mockups. Most of the time, I literally take my wireframe and just start dragging and dropping photos, adding colors and typography when it comes time to design. In the wireframing phase, you want to come up with multiple solutions. So don't get too hung up on one wireframe. Instead, move along and create another one. How many different solutions can you create to solve the same problem? In doing so, you'll find the best option. Now that I've created the mobile wireframe versions, I'm going to be adding these to the wireframe kit I created. If you're interested in getting your hands on that and using this kit as a way to create your wireframes, I'll leave a link below so you can check it out and purchase the kit. I often update and improve my wireframe kit as time goes by. If you have any requests on what you would like added to a wireframe kit that you would use, let me know by leaving a comment below and I'll find a way to add it in. Here are side-by-side comparisons of the mobile and desktop version of the same wireframe idea. You can see how the layout shifts from mobile to desktop. This one was super long, so I ended up cropping it. And that's how you can create wireframes for desktop and mobile. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like and subscribe for more. Let me know in the comments below what you'd like to see next.